2011 marks 20 years since Formula One first visited the Circuit de Catalunya, and from Mansell and Senna battling in 1991 to Vettel and Hamilton last year, we've got quite a lot to look back on. Now, after scoring a point in 2010, the only Catalan in the field is hoping for more of the same as Formula One returns to Barcelona.
And I welcome you to Spain and the Spanish Grand Prix in Catalonia.
So that's quite a selection of trophies you've got downstairs, but this is the big one, isn't it?
Yeah, this is, I think, the most important one and the one which was most difficult, for sure.
Yeah, obviously you were the youngest ever British Formula 3 champion as well at the time.
Yeah, well, it was the first year in Formula 3 and it was in England. It was a very nice championship, to be honest, and I had really good remembers from racing with Trevor Carlin and as well racing in the British tracks. I really miss this feeling of racing in the UK. I spend my time producing and making music, especially this last year. On the winter, I really enjoy composing music, and it really helps me to, you know, like get away from what is the common thing about Formula One and racing. And it's a nice help, and obviously it helps you to, you know, get a better mind or everything, you know.
I noticed the Red Bull fridge there.
Ah, for sure. Red Bull is always connected because it's an energy drink and it's always connected to racing. Young feeling, and you know, it's always passion, you know, for the drink, and also it's connected to music.
So Jaime, first of all, thank you for letting us into your beautiful home here, taking the risk to let TP updates in like this, and amazing weather at the moment. So let's hope it stays the same for the race at the weekend.
Yeah, hopefully, you know, it's starting to be nice here in Barcelona, and I think it will be like this till September or so. It's so beautiful to live here, and one of the reasons why I do live here is mainly because of the weather.
Now, obviously, the start of the season hasn't been the easiest for Toro Rosso so far. How would you sum up the first four races?
It has been a bit of a difficult season, especially because we have so many things different than last year. But you know, I think we need to stay calm and positive because we had, you know, a bit of everything in the first races. I did 9 laps in the race of China because we lost to win. You know, we failed in Malaysia, so we couldn't start the season as we wanted. But you know, I think we are all doing a good job in general. I think the car is more competitive than last year. I think there's potential to come. There's a bit more as well from my side to understand better the tyres and to have a bit less decoration for the race on Sunday. And obviously, you know, it's just to put everything in the paper, because we know that last year to this year it's been very difficult. It's been very different than last year. But you know, we're just on the way, and sooner or later we'll get some nice weekends and some points finishes.
Obviously there's quite a few changes this year. Kurs has come back, DRS is new. How are you finding the DRS? Are you enjoying it?
Well, this is not really a compromise, because at the end, you know, you have the winter testing to get used to it, you have, you know, all the Fridays to get used. It's not a big problem. I mean, we can really survive with this. It's the same for everyone, and you know, it's not so difficult to adapt to that situation. I really felt more the tyre change than last year. You know, how do you find the grip level, or how does the tyre goes off the grade, or how do you maintain the wear of the tyre alive? So it's been a bit more difficult this year than last year, but you know, it's a different kind of racing that you need to understand, and it's all about having this extra grip that you need.
Obviously you've lived here all your life and you've gone through a lot of emotions through motorsport since you've been here. Going right back to the very beginning, obviously Fernando Alonso, for example, always aspired to be a Formula One driver. In your case it wasn't quite the same, was it? Was Formula One always there, always the target for you?
Absolutely no. I mean, I started when I was 8 years old in Catalonia, in this region, and I started just racing go-karts because I liked it and I enjoyed it. And since now it has been really like this, to enjoy my present, to enjoy what I do. Obviously I want to be world champion one day. This is, I think, the main target for all the drivers wearing Formula 1.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's been like this, to enjoy the present, to really be very grateful to Red Bull, which has been my main sponsor always. And without them I wouldn't be here, absolutely no. With them I could win Formula 3, with them I could reach Formula 1 and score my first points. So, absolutely, I am totally with my brand, with my team, which is the Red Bull Junior team since I was 15 years old, and now it's the Scuderia Toro Rosso. So for me, it has been always like this. I think Formula 1 has never been really a objective of a target. Obviously, you wanted to reach there, but if not, you know, you were just having a really nice experience of life, and you were just experiencing something really amazing.
Going right back to the beginning of the Formula 1 career, obviously you replaced Brendan Hartley as the reserve driver for Toro Rosso and Red Bull, and then Sebastian Bourdais suddenly left Toro Rosso, and all of a sudden you were there the 2009 Hungarian Grand Prix. You'd hardly ever driven a Formula 1 car around a corner before that weekend. What do you remember going into that weekend?
Well, it was definitely my hardest year ever in Formula 1, in single seater racing. It was very difficult to finish the races, and definitely it was very difficult to understand the car. How much of a difference was a front wing, how much of a difference was a setup change or a downforce change. It's very difficult to feel the actual car. In Formula 1 racing, it's just about feeling. If you don't have this feeling right, you're never going to be 120%. And therefore you need experience, therefore you need the testing, you need to see so many things, you need bad days, you need good days. And this is all about Formula 1, it's just a number of changes.
I remember at the time a lot of people said, oh, this guy has got no chance, he's coming in and he's sitting in this car for the first time, he's never even hardly driven Formula 1.
No, it's impossible.
What were your emotions going down the pit lane in practice for the first
time? I was feeling exactly the same, but obviously I had the support from Red Bull because they supported me from 15 years old.
Yeah.
I think it was a bit of danger, just not for me, also for the image of Red Bull, because it was really not a good, it was not really a clear decision for everyone, yeah, it was not so clear. So when we all decided to drive for Toro Rosso in 2009, it was very difficult for me to understand. It was very difficult to me to achieve the goals everyone wanted, because I couldn't.
Mm.
And it was difficult, yeah. Nevertheless, you know, I did a good pre-season testing, and I did a good pre-season, you know, training and so on. And in 2010, I could fight back. And I was just starting to build up. In 2009, we've seen some development in qualifying, but it was always very difficult, you know, to understand the actual car feeling and emotions and everything.
This year now is quite important for you and Sebastian, your teammate. It's looking almost certain now that Daniel Ricciardo will get a Toro Rosso race seat next year. So are you feeling a strain or a tension in the team, almost a personal battle with Sebastian to stay in the team?
Well, I think it's always a personal battle with your teammate, because in the end he's the one who has your same machine, your same tools.
Yeah.
But at the end, I know Sebastian is a really good driver. I really know that we are both pushing every Friday session, every single qualifying and every single race. So we are really on the limit of the time. And I knew that both of us deserve to be in Formula 1, me and himself. So at the moment, this is what I can feel. You know, it's a long season, it's a lot of races to go. Formula 1 has really changed a lot since last year. You really need to understand it, and you really need to adapt yourself to new Formula 1. And the one who adapts better is the one who's going to beat the other. It's a bit like this.
Best of luck for the race this weekend.
Thank you.
Fingers crossed, it'll be a good one. You scored the points obviously last year, coming from 15th, I think, on the grid.
Yeah.
So maybe the same again.
Thank you, hopefully, yeah.
Thanks.
Thank you. Best of luck.